死ぬ。
Hey, what's up guys, Indian Sensei here, welcome back to another episode of Ninja Voltage. Today I'm gonna talk about fan favorite Itachi Uchiha. And I know I was supposed to make a video on Rinne Sharingan, but a lot of people wanted Itachi and I got a lot of comments about it, so I had to do it. Well, Itachi is my second favorite in the anime, and in this game, which is Rekit, he immediately became Attack Mission God. He was introduced during the very first start of the game, and the Rekit came after almost 2 years ago. He was top tier as Attack Mission main and defender as well. People still use him in defense, and sometimes you can encounter him in final room as well, but he is not as good as he used to be. But nevertheless, we are gonna talk about his early days in this game and why he lags behind. If that sounds interesting, let's jump to episode number 4 of the series. In Attack Mission, the ideal kit would be his Rekit Ultimate and Mangekyo Sharingan 4-star along with the Shurikens and Teleport. The ideal kit of him in defense would be Yata Mirror, Shurikens, Mangekyo Sharingan and the new ultimate. Starting off with the good points, 3-star Shurikens used to do very good amount of damage and were able to one-shot the enemy. If you added some manipulate power tools on him, he could easily one-shot any top tier defender back in the days. CP cost and cooldown both are very low, which is ideal for using it multiple times. 3-star Teleport, although doesn't do any damage, but believe me, it plays a crucial role in his kit that made him so overpowered. For countering his teleport, we had to fill fortress with walls. Also, teleport was very useful in avoiding ultimates as a main as well as defense, because back in the days there were not many big range ultimates. 4-star Mangekyo Sharingan inflicts medium paralysis and dot damage, which was a big part of his combo. The combo was teleport towards the enemy, use Mangekyo Sharingan and hit the Shurikens once or twice. Enemy is done most of the times. Now coming on to his Rekit ultimate, Yasaka Beats. I never got his old or new ultimates, so that was sad. Yasaka Beats was one of the best ultimates in the game at that time. Covers a good range, multi-hit, low cooldown. Also, if enemy survives, then inflicted with attack debuff and slowed movement, both are large. He is a blue character. He didn't face any CP issues back in the days, but he will now because of the CP eating installations and low damage from the Shurikens. If you plan to use him in Attack Mission, I would strongly recommend taking a healer and sealer with you. And someone like Ashura will help you in spamming jutsus. The problem with him now is that the ultimate range is not that good. It's okay, but not on par with the current ultimates in the game. Especially in final room, the enemies might move away from you, resulting in the ultimate getting missed. As the game kept introducing other OP defenders and Attack Mission mains, his ranking gradually decreased. And as of now, Attack Mission main he is mid B tier and defense he is low A tier. Same goes for the final room. So why did this happen? First of all, his Shurikens don't do as much damage as they used to. They are basically a nerfed version of Itachi V3 Shuriken now. He has no trap clear, so cannot keep his team together. If you remember a while back, his Shurikens got bugged and they cleared traps. I wish it was still here. But anyways, it's not here, so. Teleport Jutsu doesn't give any kind of buff or damage. Most of our teleports nowadays come with some kind of special effect, like Shisui has his speed and evasion, Jubito has his buffs and damage, Indra has his paralysis, but Itachi sadly has nothing besides a small teleport. Same goes with Sharingan. The paralysis is like for 5 seconds. It was good before because he could kill the enemy in that time duration with his Shurikens, but now he ends up leaving the enemy health to less than 40%. Due to the dot effects and the Shurikens. At max level, the cooldown of it is like 8 seconds, so you cannot use it again immediately. Basically a nerf version of Indra's flashing eye of countless blooms, which has paralysis, slowed movement and a bigger range. Both of his ultimates are easily avoidable even with small iframes. He doesn't have any seal or a decent iframe. I mean, he has Yata Mirror, but it's not really suitable for Attack Mission. So he has to rely on his Mangekyo Sharingan and the Shuriken Jutsus to continuously inflict damage. When up against a high damaging defender, he can easily get one-shotted. So without the help of support, he is not gonna survive in the current meta. As a defender, he lacks the fight control because of lack of sealing and AoE Jutsus. So basically, he needs a whole new kit with good 4 stars and a better ultimate. If you want to use him in Meta Fortress, then make sure to take top tier supports, because they will help you out when you are inflict with dot damage or something like that. Soloing with him in the current Meta Fortress, especially in Gokunin, with all the chakra eating installation and the tornado traps, as I always say, is not advised. I don't think you can solo with him in the current Meta Fortress, to be honest. As this game keeps on introducing more meta character, his ranking is just gonna drop much faster. Unless he gets some whole new kit, just like my boy Hokage Naruto. So now coming on to the conclusion. He used to be good, and he was a god in attack mission, but now he has fallen. While stealing my own lines from the Shisui episode. But you can have fun playing with him in team attack missions. Hopefully he gets a good Riri kit, which can make him a top tier again. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to drop down a like and comment, and let me know what you think about this video. And if you are new, hit that subscribe button and bell icon. Follow my social medias, links in description. Also, you can watch my other episodes of this series. They will be in the playlist section. I'll see you next time. Sayonara.